This is Strong and Sassy. It's your superstation, Joy 99.7 FM. My name is Enimo Enimado, and we'll be doing this until 8 o'clock. And I'm super excited, as always, to be having this conversation today. Today we're talking about scams. So in the past few weeks, there are two major movie series that, you know, have kind of been trending on social media about scams in relation to, you know, love affairs and getting people interested in you. There was Tinder Swindler, which, you know, made waves, and Inventing Anna also, which is a series. And both of these kind of deal with how people get into, you know, relationships with other people with a plan to extort money or, you know, get houses or whatever, and the strategies that are used. And so tonight we want to talk about that to help you to avoid becoming a victim. And there's so many real life stories. So, you know, Aram, who is on the show very often, mm-hmm. I met her earlier on today, and she was telling me her personal story mm-hmm. of how some dude tried to scam her.
Wow.
Yeah, around Christmas. Came up to her in a nice hotel, you know, said he was renting, you know, apparently some big boy too. And so in one of the interactions, he was like, he was so busy on his phone, and she was like, oh, what's going on? I was like, Charlie, I did try send money. Trying to send money to the guy, my momo no they work. Charlie, can you send 500? Oh no, Shimi has collected the 500. No, Charlie. The matter spoil. She had to threaten him to get her money back eventually.
Wow.
So, you know, there are lots of personal stories and experiences that people have had, you know, when it comes to that. So we'll get into that conversation. But let me say good evening to my guests. Very beautiful women in the studio. It is your best bet is to turn off the radio and go to Facebook Live, honestly, because you definitely want to see our faces. And we're live on Facebook, so you can watch us. But, you know, if you have to drive and you're in your car, well, I guess our voices will have to do. So we have Esi Sika Manfa. She's an entrepreneur joining us again. Good evening and welcome.
Thank you so much
for being here tonight. And we have Jennifer Della Arthur, who's an administrative assistant. Jennifer, it's your first time.
Yes.
So you're very welcome.
Thank you.
To the squad. And of course, our resident assassin, Esina Mbata.
You know the name, right?
I know the name. Let me say a good evening to all our assassins, Adipa, Aram, and Ifwa. Good evening to you guys. And also a very big thank you to my friends at DVLA. You guys were fantastic today for us. I really appreciate that. Okay, so let's get into the conversation.
Yes.
Scams. So, you know, I feel like we really want to hear your experiences. So send us your messages, 055-111-1997. I want to hear your stories. Anybody has tried to scam you. And we'll open the phone lines at some point. And then, you know, you can comment in the comment section on Facebook as well, because we'd love to hear stories. So, Esinam, let me start with you.
Mm-hmm.
Any experiences?
I have not met anyone who's into scamming for money. I mean,
Are you the scammer?
Oh, wow!
I mean, we have to ask.
No, I'm not.
No?
No, never okay. been interested in that.
In scamming.
In scamming, okay. In taking other people's money. But scammers exist.
Mm.
Right. And people who prey on basic human emotions and decency and courtesy. Like people who leverage on love, people leverage on fear, people who take advantage of other people just to take, even if it's not money, but to take from them. With no intentions of reciprocating or even giving back if they took money. And that exists a lot, especially in our part of the world where we place premium on marriage and the need to be have your own family and all that. When women are at a certain age and they are not married yet, then there's a teeny weeny hint of desperation that comes in. And for some women, and so, well, some people also recognize it as investment opportunity, or they are entrepreneurs. The basic definition for entrepreneurship is taking advantage of an opportunity to make money, no? So you took advantage of an opportunity in your field. You discovered a challenge and you provided a solution and you are making money off of it. That's what they also think they are doing. That they've discovered a challenge, which is women above 30 needing love.
Mm.
They pose as the solution to the challenge, and then they make money off of it. Unfortunately, this is very short lasting. Very, very short lasting.
But I mean, from your statement, are you saying that it's only women who fall prey to
No. There are
to the scam. It's, no. It's both ways, isn't
it's
it?
It's both ways, but we have, as a society, normalized women taking from men. So
that one is not scamming.
So it has become like it's not. It is scamming. But because we've normalized it, it's become like, okay, it's either you're a gold digger or not, but you're not labeled as a scammer.
As
do you get it? As opposed
guy.
To when it's a when it's a guy, then we call him a scammer.
Mm.
You know?
Okay. So let's talk about what these scams look like. So Essie, let me come to you. I mean, from your experience or from stories that you've heard and stuff, what do these scams look like? And like, what are some of the things that kind of give you an indication that Charlie, this is going
a criminal?
Yeah.
Well, they come off as too good to be true.
Mm-hmm.
I think they come off as too good to be true, and they their lifestyles, yes, their lifestyles also tell them, their friends, the kind of things that they do, their stories never add up.
Okay.
They never add up. They are telling you for an example, with a Tinder swindler, he said he was in a family, like his family was into diamond business and
yeah.
all that. But as a family person, you expect that one way or the other, their parents will be talking to you, having meetings, you know, talking about their business. But it was all about the glam, all
yeah.
about the lifestyle, like flying here, having. He was never a home person. How do you can tell from that this person is telling something that is not true?
Okay, so basically when it's but you see when you say something is too good to be true, because there are men out there who are legit.
Yeah, me.
So there definitely have to be like indicators. Okay. So
right.
Should we bring Jennifer in and then before you?
Oh, let's Jennifer enter the conversation.
Okay, so what do you think? For you, what are the things that kind of indicate that?
Okay, I think there are a lot of red flags. Sometimes it moves really fast.
Mm.
You know, you from talking stage. Sometimes I feel real relationships, the talking stage is quite lengthy. But then with this coming relationships, you feel that it moves really, really fast. You don't even know when, and then it's moving too fast, too real. It's becoming too real. And then, as she said, too good to be true. Like, the Tinder swindler like this. I think the first lady, I forgot her name. Is she selling or something?
I forgot her name.
Yeah. I feel she should be able to know that there is something at stake. When the guy just employed her, you've not been to an interview, nothing of that
but
sort.
He owns the company. I mean,
yes, but then your salary was just like
over the roof.
Over the
but
roof.
Her salary was over the roof because he was trying to pay her back. And
no.
So, I mean, I don't even think that's so much of a scam as that was fraud, because that's something that people do. I mean, I don't want to say it has happened in politics, you know. Ghost payroll,
yeah.
You know, so it was kind of something like that. Is that does that necessarily mean that there's you know something to scam you personally?
I wouldn't say that. No, but then this one, you should know that. And then in the first, I think in the first month, the salary didn't even hit the account. And she still kept on sending money.
You haven't been scammed before.
Okay.
Oh,
I know somebody has some experience.
Process, then you'd realize that it's not that simple. It's not that straightforward.
Yeah.
It really isn't.
Yeah.
You know, when they come, they approach you. And in
what are you tackling now?
They're scammers.
This is our resident consultant.
Yes,
on
scammers. Because knowing my reputation and my background
expertise.
In knowing Kaftan boys and their criminal activities. This is Kaftan Pro Max. The romance scammers.
Wow.
They are Kaftan Pro Max.
I see.
So
okay.
Apart from their physicals, which Kaftan is a key
really
ingredient.
Okay, go ahead. So tell
well,
us what the process is like.
They approach you.
Okay.
when they approach you, they don't come like they want a relationship or anything. They come like they just want to make you happy. I am just here to make you happy. And it seems legitimate because there are some times that you have instant connections with people.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe you are not even desperate, but you're just open to loving.
Yeah.
And then they take advantage of your openness to be loved. But then let's just even not get there yet. They come to you, they approach you in a very nice way, you start talking, the talking stages are all well and good. It doesn't have to be flashy, it doesn't have to be glamorous, but the attention shown you is unlike something you've seen before.
Mm-hmm.
The dedication, the commitment, because like I said, it is their job. So they pay full attention to it. It's you they are texting all through the day. It's you they are calling all through the day. And they make you feel over the top, too special.
Mm-hmm.
You think that you're the only person in their world.
Yeah.
And then they introduce some few complications. The complication stage. Oh, my family is sick.
So the first stage is the
what? It's the intro stage or introduction stage.
Then we move to there.
We move to the too good to be true stage. Yeah, then we move to complications.
Okay.
They introduce the complications where it's either a family member.
And you don't, if you're listening to us, don't worry. You don't have to write all of it down. Esinam is going to write an article about all of this, and it'll be on myjoyonline.com so that you know what to look out for. So, yes, go on.
Then they come in with challenges. It's not a huge challenge. They would throw one in there, or maybe. There's a business deal they were looking for that's not going through.
Mm-hmm.
But at that stage, they had shown you some affection that you've not felt before. They've won your trust. The key word is trust.
Mm-hmm.
They have won you.
They've potentially spent money on you.
Exactly. Yeah. Potentially, it could be that they could spend money on you. It could also be that they don't spend money on you, but they just... love you. They just love you like you want to be loved.
Mm-hmm.
They say all the things you want to hear.
Yeah.
They do all the things you want to see. Do you get it? And then they build the trust on that level. So they built you in. They've sort of given you their offering, and you bought it, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Then they move on to the stage where they introduce some complications. Oh, there's a business deal I'm working on that's not going well, and all that. They won't ask you for the money. No.
Mm-hmm.
It will be too obvious.
Mm-hmm.
They will solve it. They'll go and borrow from somebody to fix it. Then they'll tell you that, oh, this happened and Kwame gave me this and sorted me out. And so I'm good on this level. So I'm waiting on the consignment and the shipment. And I'm waiting on this and I'm waiting on that.
I'm removing the list.
Oh,
it's not time for the list yet.
We'll come to that.
Because we have a list.
A list?
Yes. Yo,
plenty lines.
The list of what the scam lines.
Then you build the trust. Then the next thing. They bring a bigger complication, and then they'll say that I've been able to solve half.
No.
You to add the remaining half to it. Meanwhile, there's no problem.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So there's this story I heard. I think it was Rosalind Feli who was telling me the last time I was at Sixth Sense that there's this karma in Ghana, right, who approaches these big women, and the same MO, he will show you love and everything, and then he will tell you that he's bought a car for you.
No.
Okay? The car will be delivered to you at home and everything, all well and nice. You are loving the car. You are enjoying. He will tell you that he's paid 40% of the car. So you send 60% when...
I think I know the story.
Okay.
When he's... when he gets money, he will reimburse you. He's working on something. When he's done, he will reimburse you. You pay the 60%, you'll be driving the car nicely, jejali, and people will meet you in town and beat you, collect the car from you.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yes. Lawu for you.
Yes.
I'm serious. It's happening in this Ghana. Yeah, gang.
Yes. I think
you've heard it.
Yes. It happened to someone close to me. Yes.
Seriously?
Yes. But I didn't know it was a scam until
it's a scam.
because the person didn't succeed.
How does he get you to trust that he's paid 40%?
Mm.
But by being in your system, he uses romance. They use the things that you need or you fear. Two things. It is what innately we want as human beings that people use to scam us. It's greed. It's the need for too much money. It's like It is what we want as human beings, which could be fundamental, as little as wanting to be liked, that people use to scam us.
Romance, kindness, the promise of marriage,
yes,
the promise of children,
yes,
the promise of going outside of the country. For whatever,
exactly.
All those things. And so they suddenly make the impossible reachable.
Exactly.
Yeah. And then you trust.
Yes.
Because they actually make a conscious effort to prove their credibility.
Thank you.
And then, so by the time they're asking you for money, you know, and it's funny because when all of this came up, so I have this friend, well, he's a lot older than me. He's a very, very dear friend. And I go to him when I need, like if there's an emergency or something, I would say, oh, can you send me, you know, maybe 1,000 CDs, or can you send me 2,000 CDs as soon as I, you know, so I'll give it back to you. So sometimes I'll collect money from him in the morning and give it back by the evening.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But we've done it very often. So we're kind of almost at the point where I built enough credibility that I could ask him for anything.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And because, you know, over the past few years, it's always been a, but I realized that that's a great setup for a scam.
A scam, uh-huh. Yeah.
And if you're listening, I'm not planning on scamming you. I'm just saying it's a great, but it's a great setup for a scam because I've taken the time to build. So, you know,
trust.
It's 1,000, it's 2,000, it's 1,000, then you send it back.
And
you don't keep,
back.
You know, it's,
yeah.
It's 2,000. Oh, I need to pay for this quickly. I don't have Momo. Can you, he'll send it. I'm like, oh, I'll pop into the bank in the afternoon. Pop into the bank, I'll send it back. Then I could hit him like, yo, I need 40K to, I don't know if he would think about it too much.
Too
because
much. He won't.
Because
The trust has been
boom.
Built.
Yeah, and that's
the number you are trying to reach.
You have dialed the wrong number.
I think it's the time. They have a specific time.
Oh, yes.
The time frame that they have to
they
do.
They know
what
by then
exactly.
The trust has
like
been built.
The duration of the contract.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So you
in
enjoy to a point.
Yes. In the MO, there's a time, you know, at what stage we progress to different stages of the scamming scheme, you know. At the intro stage, if it lasts for more than 2 weeks, they know that we're in far, so they will abandon it. But they know that once they get your attention in the first week,
that's it. Wow. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, but this guy who is doing this car thing, and the thing is, I've actually heard a lot of people talk about how they were scammed when it comes to them trying to buy cars. So it's definitely a thing.
Yeah,
I mean, the guy says,
but anyone, this one, you didn't even say you wanted
the
car.
No.
This
person
says,
I'm
upgrading you.
If you're not careful, they'll collect the
old one.
Bring
yeah.
the new one.
Yes.
You use this, then in the middle of traffic, no.
That's
it. Wait. You know, there was a time when I was, you know, the Bush Canteen Road in East Egon. And this two women, they weren't actually Ghanaian. I think they were Middle Eastern. They were driving a Range Rover. And some guy had stopped them in the middle of the road to collect the car.
Yeah.
Giddy giddy, oh. And so on Lucas, it could, I'm not saying that was what it was, but
it
that's
could
what
have
it
been.
Probably looks like. Like you are driving, literally.
Yes.
Stop. You stop. Hey.
You'll be confused.
No.
I mean, you won't even
so
know.
So they've been trailing
like,
you
they
for
allow
some
you to
time.
Clean the boots and take out your makeup?
No,
they are
taking your makeup. They will take the car from you, collect the keys, and then off they go. And then, obviously, around that time, the car is not registered in your name.
So
if you're driving a Yaris and minding your business, somebody has come to collect it and said, I'll buy you Camry. They've collected the Yaris, brought you Camry.
No, they come and collect
you added it. Some money to it. Then you are driving in the middle of the road, minding your business, probably playing some Camido sugarcane, enjoying yourself. then I want you break. Stop, bring my car.
So embarrassing.
It's heartbreaking.
And all because of love. All because of the need to be liked.
But you know, some of these come turn into blackmailing. Yes, because I know of an incident that happened with a lady. This guy came in as a doctor, came in trying to woo her, went as far as meeting the family. Meeting the family, I mean, the lady had a child, meeting the child, picks the child from school. Then he wants to have sex. The lady says no. It turns into an argument, the end of a relationship. She sees another person in the same situation with this guy. But, I mean, I can't come and approach you and tell you that this is what happened. Later finds out that the guy blackmailed the lady. She was a very she was at the top office in her organization, and you know, you can't disclose such things to anybody.
Wow.
Yes. And it went on and on.
I feel like we should be able to do like background checks.
Checks.
Now. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Aram was saying that if you meet a boy that you want to date, post his picture on Instagram and let people and look, Facebook and let people come and give you comments.
Absolutely mad. Hi, Golda. Good evening. Golda started dating her boyfriend, who we all know. She posted him on Facebook and said, "This is management. Is he anybody else's?"
Thank
I
you.
Was like, I texted her, I was like, are you mad?
There, you be there. Don't do it.
Check. Yeah, you need to do background checks.
Like, who's this is my boo? Is he anybody else's boo? I mean, but right now the background check, if I do police background check,
yes,
you have to do credit. Okay, well, outside it's called credit score, but like in Ghana, like your credit, you know, whether you owe and stuff. And you have to do spiritual background check.
Yes, exactly. Family
background check. Family background, because some cousins are baby mamas. it's not easy for women these days. So.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, so from what stage are we at?
We're at the after the complication, then bigger complications, then the scam.
Then the actual scam. Okay, so what does the actual scam look like?
The actual scam ranges. It could be financial. It could be blackmail, as she said. But it is taking something from you that you are expecting that there will be a payback, but you don't get that payback. So they can take money from you. They can cause you to borrow money for them. And in most cases, it's money.
Yeah.
You do too many things. You sell your properties. You sell your cars, you sell your land, you sell a lot of things just, you know, to give to this person to sort out their problem.
Sometimes
you
it's think, just this happening.
And I think as human beings, we have hero complex.
You want to do something.
Yes, we women, we have hero, because we are nurturers, we want to be wife material and caring and loving.
I don't think when it's women, it's called hero complex. I think it's more like maybe the virtuous woman complex.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Okay.
Or something.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So Proverbs 21. No, Proverbs 21 complex.
31.
Hey.
You have taken the title from me.
Oh, no.
The name is Tinamua. The title has been handed for quoting wrong Bible scriptures.
Oh, the 31 and 21. Go, there's a one. So Proverbs 31 complex.
Yeah.
The need for women.
So we're calling it what? P31 complex.
Yes, P31 complex.
Okay. The need for women to be seen as superwomen.
Yes, wife supportive, material, supportive, wife loving. Yeah. I don't want to be look at the gold digger here. I'm down for you. I'm your ride or die.
Ride,
where
are we riding to?
Ride,
he will ride you
and die.
But because of all these things,
literally what it means, ride or die.
Because of all these things, when actually something is happening to someone and I'm trying, like I have a conflict in my head about whether to help or not to help, or whether I feel as if this test, if it's a test that failed, if anybody's
water and my business,
really
drink water and my business.
Okay, so we're going to take a quick commercial break. Go and drink water.
Mind your business.
Still strong and sassy. We're talking about getting scammed, because we really don't want you to get scammed. So stay tuned in. When we come back, we will read your messages, and we would love to hear from you, your stories and your experiences as well. Stay tuned in. We'll be right back.
February 28, 1948. On this day, 6 shots fired into a crowd of peaceful demonstrators will spark the uprising of the Gold Coast's eventual independence from the British colonial rule and the formation of Ghana. Parable Studios, in collaboration with Animation Africa, presents 28th, The Crossroads, the animated feature film recreating the event leading to the Christian Bok Crossroads shooting incident. Come experience history unfold live on the big screens with Ghana's first animated feature film, 28th, The Crossroads, premiering on the Silverbird Cinemas at Crown Mall on February 28th at 7 p.m. Rate is 50 Ghana cedis regular and 40 Ghana cedis for the early bird ticket. Tickets are available at Maxmart, Airport Shell, Bachona Total, and at Silverbird Cinemas. Dial *899*60# for short code purchase or visit www.studioparables.com for online purchase. 28th, The Crossroads is a story of hope, determination, love, and tragedy with a sweet outcome.
Welcome back. This is still Strong and Sassy here on Joy 99.7 FM. My name is Enima Nimado, and I'm sitting down with Essie, Jennifer, and Essinam, and we're talking about getting scammed. So that hopefully you won't get scammed, because the scammers these days are they are a scam. They're very good at what they do. So what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna take a few of your messages, and then I'm gonna have Essinam go through. There was this thing that was out on social media this week about the greater scam lines or the most common scam lines, and Essinam has you've lost it.
I broke my phone this morning.
Oh yeah, you broke your phone. Okay, so she's going to go through the greatest scam line so that when you hear it, you know
that is a scam.
Okay, so gone are the days when you are introduced to your partner's family, it means you're getting married. Now, it's all part of the format. People get dropped in the middle of nowhere all the time. You can actually meet a fake family.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
but people can actually take you to meet a group of people.
A group of friends,
friends, but people that are paid. Because literally, Ghana is so hard right now.
Some actually form a syndicate of scams.
You get ladies acting like a mother.
Grandchildren.
Yeah.
They take you to the home. Yeah, and it's like it's so well set up. That's Nana Kwesi. Good evening. It's such an interesting and relevant topic. And people come around me, ladies, just to extort money from me due to my body size, although I'm a grown-up man. You're small. Okay. This has repeatedly happened and is making me lose interest in going after ladies. That's Stephen from Empresso Kwesi South. I'm small in size. Oh, Stephen. Okay, this one says, I sort of this lady's story. I had a crush on her. She's with this guy that apparently she went into a relationship with because the guy had money. She has kids with the guy now and wants to opt out because now the money no they come like before. I've been scammed in my effort to help Ghanaian own goods on credit. If I tell you I've lost over 100,000 cedis, you wouldn't believe me. To all these people, I wish them nothing good from the death and birth of my soul. Lovely ladies. Yeah, I mean, it's always very painful to be duped or scammed or have somebody tell you that. It's also, I've also noticed that sometimes people scam you in the smallest ways, even before the big one.
Yeah.
So you sometimes say, oh, Charlie, scam like light. Essinam, I'll call you Essinam. Charlie. I'm at Honeysuckle. I'm really trying to pay my bill and it's not good. This is me and you.
Yeah.
Charlie, make you send me 450. Then you send. Then 2 days later, they're like, your name's Chale, my 450. I'm like, Chale, I did go bank right now. Then phone dead. That's scam lights.
Yes.
I did a money transfer. Has it not come? Check your account. Oh,
MTN is messing up.
Yeah, that's so true.
My account has been blocked because I tried to do it so many times. And then for 3 weeks, the 450
will never come.
Until my Christmas bonus to receive the 450.
Wow.
That's scam lighting.
Yes, that's scam lighting.
So those who do that, stop.
Stop.
Okay, let's go through the scam lines.
Oh, okay. So the first one is...
I think we should do something funny. If Essinam, if you're listening to us, we can't hear you, but if she reads a scam line and you can relate, I think you should say I. Okay, so let's go.
Babe, send me money. My enemies are after me. Number two, my container is on the sea.
UK boys in December.
Aye.
Send me your CV.
Aye.
It's not about the sex.
Aye.
I'm not talking to any guys right now.
Aye.
I ask you people have been doing it to them.
No. The other way around. I'm not talking to any girls right now.
We don't need any titles. Let's just go with the flow.
Yeah. Oh. That's a good one. Yeah.
This is between us for now.
It's a secret.
I'm not like the other guys.
It's a lie. Big lie.
I'm a German heiress with 60 million, but my dad has cut me off.
Oh, yeah. That's the inventing Anna.
That's the inventing Anna. Anna. Yeah.
Okay.
Just the tip.
We are virgins.
Just
this is a
you
one.
See how you put on here. You see how you put on here. Just the tip, dear. Everybody. It's either just the tip or brush. Wow.
I'm
not here.
I don't know what
to talk about.
This is
a once in a lifetime opportunity. I come from a French country and I don't understand English. I don't usually do this.
I don't usually do this.
It's easy. Just bring two people. Who will bring two people and watch your money grow? May I interest you in butt or breast enlargement lotion?
No, I haven't seen that one.
I wish I met you before I met my wife.
Aye.
That's like the married man's line.
Yes.
The
line. Yes. We are not that serious. Mm. We sleep in separate rooms. Mm. We are having issues.
Oh, yes.
She's
it was
not
my
there.
Mother who said I should marry her.
Because she got pregnant, I had to marry her.
She's cheating on me. She's not. Hey, married men are great.
Yes. But I
wish I met you before my wife.
All the time.
Like if I had met you, I would never have married. Somebody told me that. Now I'm not remembering. Some nice man, Bill, like 5 years ago. I really believed him the way he said it. He really was like, you know, if I had met, and he had a British accent, it's like, if I had met you, I'd never have been able to look at another woman. But it was like it was my fault because he didn't meet me, so he had to marry somebody else. So his life was miserable
because
he didn't meet me, and he had to marry somebody. So now that I've met you,
he
you just
scum.
Have to take me like that.
It's a scam.
It is a scam.
Another one. That's my best friend.
Okay.
I am only with her for the kids. I wanted to go, but it's because of the kids.
The
you
kids,
see.
I'm still
you see
seeing.
The kids.
Yeah, you know, we have to raise.
I would have gone that.
If I'm not even there, I'm just there as a father.
I just come in and you know.
You know the one that dies. I'm just there as a father. I don't love her. All of that. Then. A few months later, the wife born another one.
Yeah,
it was a mistake.
Women are always breaking my heart.
Scam.
And then me, I don't like women. It is women who come to me. Women who like me.
Yes.
Another scam.
That's another scam.
Women move to me. I don't move to them. They are always moving to me.
That's a scam.
Yes.
Really? Yeah. I see. So when I posted this a few days ago, one of my friends sent her own list of scams. And she said one of the lines is, where have you been all my life?
Yes.
Feels like I've known you forever. And I was like, I don't think that's a scam because you actually meet people and you feel like you've known them forever.
Scam.
And she said, no, it's a scam because it leads to you are my soulmate.
Hey.
So right now, boys can't give raps anymore. Every rap is a scam.
It's a scam.
You haven't heard that I was praying and the Lord revealed you to me.
To me.
At that point, you have to ask, which Lord? Then I have to clarify.
Yes.
The Lord showed me you are my wife.
Yes.
I made a mistake and I married the first time. Because you see, there was an Ishmael before there was an Isaac.
Wow.
And my wife is the Ishmael.
Wow.
But you are the Isaac. We must let Ishmael go.
When the kids grow up.
You haven't had biblical scams.
You know, guys have also said something like, because of ladies, some ladies use this to lie to them. My pastor says you are not the right guy for me.
Yes.
They use that against the ladies a lot.
Yes.
My pastor says we should break up because you are not the right man for me.
Yes, the ladies use that.
Even the men too.
Yeah.
And the one that you can't contest is, I was praying and God said you are not my wife. Where are you going to find God to ask him? My God.
Oh God, my mother doesn't like you.
My mother doesn't like you, and also
I can't go against my family.
And then you find out that the mother does never knew you even
existed.
Mothers are broke. But you know, somebody once told me that for every man who's going into a relationship or who's going to scam, they always have an exit plan.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So when they meet you, they can tell that your exit plan would be, my mother doesn't like you because is too chappy. You like, there's always some sort of exit plan.
You know, some people use the tribalism. My mom doesn't like Elvis.
But they knew it and they still came from the beginning.
That's a scam too.
Yeah.
Yes. That's why I'm saying that the scamming is not just money, because if he's coming in just to have a good time with you and he's not upfront and honest about it, but would rather lie to you that they like you and then later on give you flimsy excuses like, my mother doesn't like, my family doesn't agree well with Airways, and so they are leaving you in the middle of nowhere. That's a scam.
You know, so that when somebody meets you and they feel like they know that we can't go the long haul, but I want your time, your body, the comforts that you give. Maybe I'm not working, so I need somewhere to perch and I need someone to feed me until I get back on my feet.
Exactly.
That's a scam as well.
It's a scam.
Yeah. But I also feel like we're being unfair because women scam men
a lot. That's true. I'm pregnant.
I feel like I'm pregnant.
I'm pregnant. Give me money for the pill and all of that. Yeah. My mother is this. I'm going to the hospital.
How are you? Hi, babe.
Hi.
How are you? Oh, babe, what's wrong? Oh, I'm hungry.
No, I think the first one is nothing. What's wrong?
Nothing.
Are you sure?
Talk to me, babe. I'm not eating. Okay, so what would you eat?
You want to go and get food? Go and get food. Why?
I don't have money.
I'm really broke.
And then I need a favor.
Yes.
And then 2K urgently.
Urgently.
2K I need 2K urgently.
Urgently.
Wow. I'll give it back. 2K urgently.
It never comes back.
Something that I do now, and it's really fun. When somebody says me I need a favor, I just say no.
I don't want to commit to Jesus Christ. I need a favor, not available. I will pay you later for
Anyway, let me take a few more messages. I was scammed by this person who claimed to be a pastor. His check of 15,000 CDs is still with me since December 2017. Wow. Okay, before the Tinder swindler, there was Faith Mensa Tekmo. He's still a legend. Google him.
Yes.
Wow. Okay. Do you want to just Google him so you can tell us about it quickly? Very good conversation. Kinsley, hi. Good evening. Thank you. I'm taking notes. My question is, how can you detect that a scammer, that someone's a scammer, because there are a lot in this world. Scammers in relationships are seen to be real pretenders. How do we handle such people? Also, are contract marriages an act of scamming? My name is Samuel Kojo. Kojo, hi, I'm Samuel. Hope you're okay. I mean, a contract marriage for me is you know where you're getting
exactly.
to from the beginning.
The main thing about the scamming is you don't know that this is what
You know. So if it's a mutually whatever conversation relationship, then okay. So this guy, Faith Mensa Tekpa, okay, so he is a serial defrauder. I don't know if there's a word like that. A confidence trickster, and he poses as a medical practitioner to defraud his victims.
Is that your guy? Yes,
he's the person. He's married and single men, frauds them, women, drugs them, and rapes them, and then records a sexual encounter. And then, I remember that.
Yeah,
I remember that. I think even Manasseh did something like that as well. Yeah. So, I mean, yeah, so those are, those are some of the really more serious, you know. So anyway, I think the point of tonight's conversation is be careful.
Yeah.
Be aware.
Yeah. be very, very much aware. Don't when it comes to financials,
hey, wait, these are more scam lines. I'm filing for a divorce.
Yes.
I won't do anything. Just let me see your underwear. Mm-hmm.
Hey.
I will die if you leave me. Mm. Let's go and pray is a scam. Mm. Oh, call to prayer. Nah,
it can't no, be that I think I get where he's coming from. Mm. You know, some ladies, instead of saying yes to you, be like, I'm going to pray about it.
Yeah, there's also that one. Yes. I'm going to pray about it.
Yes.
By hey. The meantime. Okay, this evening people are bringing things up. Papa Ansa, good evening. How are you? Hope you're okay. Thank you so much for tuning in. Okay, this one's asking, where's the line drawn between a lie and a scam?
A lie leads a scam.
A lie what?
Leads to a scam. A lie. A scam is lie.
Yeah.
So there's no line in between.
A liar scam.
Liar scam.
Mm, yeah. Okay, there's a story on social media. Where's that message? There's a story of a guy on social media. He connects and networks with people and then uses the opportunity to play smart on unsuspecting person. So he lends from person A. He borrows from person A. When it's time to pay back, he goes to borrow from person B to pay person
Robin
A. When
Peter
it's time to person
people.
B, he moves to person C. And then sometimes he combines people to pay one person.
Wow.
It's a very
cool
challenge like a Ponzi scheme.
Yes, they They have
Rob
no
Peter
sense.
To pay for.
You think they're
robbing Peter
pouch.
To pay for.
You think there's no notebook inside?
The captain pouch.
The pouch that comes with there's notebook inside. They just
they've everything is
so
on point.
They know what
yes,
they're
doing.
They
know what
you're lying a lot. You forget.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
You have to keep your story
straight.
Accra stay by plan.
Accra stay by plan. It's also a scam, really. Oh
no, this one, this person.
What the guy said. So they're borrowing from this to this. That one is across the
stay by
so it's not okay. Hi ladies, if you don't take care, everything a guy says or does will be a scam. How do you draw the line between scam and non-scam? Ike in the US is asking. A lady dating a scammer. Now she's scamming the scammer with a pregnancy that always terminates after four months. Yeah, some more. Right now, so the baby is born, cry. You don't even know.
But you know, with an inventing Anna, the person that she was dating, so she started dating a guy and decided, she told the guy that her trust fund will be released when she's 25 years old.
Right.
She started dating the guy at 19. So
wow.
The guy was paying for everything.
6 years.
But
my trust card will be released on 50.
But you know, she later found out that the guy was also scamming her.
Because he was waiting.
He was waiting.
Trust fund.
Yes.
Wow, that's very interesting.
Investment.
Oh my God. Anyway, a big thank you to you, AC Jennifer. And Esinam, I hope that if you're listening to us, you've learned something. I think fundamentally, really just beware of everybody. Trust no one, like they say.
Especially when it comes to money.
Yeah, especially when it comes to money. Mm-hmm. A scam, you know, scam is just around the corner waiting for you. It's unfortunate because sometimes the people we love do have genuine problems, which is why you should pray because the word of God is a two-edged sword. and it'll help. Maybe if it doesn't too, then I don't know
for you.
Right, anyway, so thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you to everybody who texted. We're handing over to George Addo Jr. and the team for football commentary, but we will be back next week Wednesday. A big thank you to Abeku, to Mirabel, to Crispy, to the whole team, Victor Brachif, who produce and put together Strong and Sassy. Thank you guys so much, and to you, of course, tuning in every week. We'll be back next week Wednesday. Stay safe out there and have a good night.